Welcome to a new Planetarian seismic update. As always, we start with the SSGI graph of the previous time frame with seismic activity projected on the graph magnitude 5.5 and larger. And what we see here is an almost one-to-one relationship with the planetary geometry, the convergence that we had three times. It started with on the 19th, but that's really related to the time frame before the 19th. But we see here on the 20th, 21st, a convergence of planetary geometry with Mercury and Venus, that's the red and purple peaks, and we see a seismic response 5.7 at the Kermadec Islands, and also a 6, it peaked magnitude 6 at Argentina, minimal clustering. Then on the 23rd, 24th, we had a high lunar peak accompanied by some critical geometry involving Mercury, Venus, that's semi-right angle geometry of Neptune, and again minimal clustering 5.6 at the Izu Islands, Japan region, and it peaked again magnitude 6, but at Sulawesi, Indonesia. And then we see on the 25th that very tight convergence, and that there was a really high red peak because of the involvement of Mercury there. And we see again an obvious seismic response on the 26th, magnitude 5.5 at Hokkaido, and also a 6.3, that's the strongest seismic event so far, magnitude 6.3 at the Mauritius Reunion region, and that is east of Madagascar. You may recall the atmospheric fluctuations that I discussed in the previous update. That was on the 23rd, and that marked, among other regions, the eastern part of Africa, and it went to the south-southeast of Madagascar. And that's close to where the 6.3 occurred. And also to the north, in Ethiopia, at the fluctuation marker, there was some seismic activity, moderate magnitude 5, not too much, but it doesn't happen very often there. And then further to the north, the eastern Mediterranean, there wasn't really strong seismic activity. It was 4.5 in Greece and also 4.2 near Cyprus. Nothing unusual, really. Again, I suspect that there could be a magnitude 6 earthquake coming up in the short term, especially near Greece, because it's been a while. I think it's over 2 years now. And so let's have a look at the next time frame. That's from the 28th of September to the 7th of October. And we see clustering of lunar and planetary geometry from the 30th until the 4th. But we also have this planetary conjunction on the 28th. That was yesterday, Mercury, Sun, Neptune. And there was also some lunar geometry, not too critical, but I have a question mark there. And that's because of the tight convergence that we had on the 25th, because so far only a 6.3 occurred, which I think is not all that much. And so there is a slight possibility, I think, that later today, maybe tomorrow, towards that lunar conjunction with Moon, Earth, Saturn on the 30th, there could be an additional seismic response, a larger earthquake, but there's a slight possibility there. So let's have a look here. From the 30th to the 4th of October, this convergence starts with Moon, Earth, Saturn, and it will be followed by Mercury, Sun, Earth. And there is some semi-right angle geometry there as well with Mercury. Then we have Moon, Earth, Neptune on the 1st of October, and that will be followed by a more critical planetary conjunction. That's Mercury, Mars, Uranus, and that is next to the new moon on the 2nd, and that will be followed by some lunar planetary geometry of Venus, that's purple, Sun, Venus, Neptune in a right angle geometry, and Venus, Mars, Jupiter is more critical, and that will be later on the 3rd. And there is 1.5 days between the Mercury, Mars, Uranus conjunction and the Venus, Mars, Jupiter conjunction. And that combination could still be somewhat critical. Not sure yet. I do expect a seismic response there from, I think, the 1st to the 3rd of October. And there could be a stronger seismic response in there, especially because of the Moon, Earth, Saturn conjunction. And then the Moon, Earth, Neptune conjunction, that is really, it's becoming a very tight convergence of lunar geometry as Saturn moves closer to Neptune. And so that around the 1st, 2nd, I think there could be a larger seismic event, probably around the 2nd. It has not really to do with the new moon. It's really because of the lunar conjunctions with Saturn and Neptune. And again, this combination Mercury, Mars, Uranus, and then Venus, Mars, Jupiter. If there is a stronger seismic response there, it could be quick, but I guess it is most likely, if that happens, around the 5th, later on the 5th, it's also possible that it will be after the Moon-Earth-Uranus conjunction on the 6th. There's uncertainty there. So we really need to see what's going to happen in the first 3 days of October with this convergence of planetary and lunar conjunctions. It's a bit of a question mark what's going to happen there with the lunar geometry. That's Earth, Moon, Venus on the 5th and Moon, Earth, Uranus on the 6th. In the solar system, real quick, we see this planetary and lunar geometry. Critical is Mercury, Mars, Uranus, like I said. That is on the 1st. And then Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and that will be on the 3rd, 1.5 days in between. That's the most critical geometry, in my opinion. And then we have Mercury, Sun, Earth, and also the lunar geometry of Saturn and Neptune. Check out the website for the latest updates, especially atmospheric fluctuations. We had some fluctuations on the 25th and on the 27th. We have dedicated channels for the latest updates. And this on Facebook, on Telegram, and on WhatsApp. And if you follow those channels, you will have a notification immediately when there is an update. Stay safe, everyone. Until next time.